The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tiger Technician Hour with your host, Basil Chapman. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, Basil Chapman.
Everyone, Basil Chapman. Yeah, Dow's down 26,941, just kind of whippy in a range. Look at this tiny range that it's been in. 27,306 in the Dow on the 12th of September. Below yesterday, I forgot to type this in here, 26,831. Let me put that in here, 26,831. And make it light because I think we're going to be going lower than that at some point. There. So what we're doing is setting up something very interesting. I spent some time yesterday talking about this. Maybe I can do it again. I don't know if this is a particular chart. Let me see if it is. Yes, it is. Okay. So the VIX right now is up 62 at 15.53. That's kind of a heavy move for the VIX, considering that the Dow is just barely down, the S&P is only about 5 points down. That makes me a little nervous when people are so quick to jump onto the negative side. All right, let's get to the nitty-gritties. One of the things that I've been talking about is the slowness in which you can get a rollover. Sometimes it's speed, like when you get, let's go to the low that was made on the upside, June the 3rd, remember the day we went long? Look at that massive V-shaped pattern. And you can get that to the downside as well. There was a very sharp pullback back on the 25th of February of this year. Dow was at 26,241. And within six sessions, it's hitting 25,650s. Most of the time, though, there's a whole series of attempts to rally that fail once the moving averages are starting to show that there is some deterioration about to come up. We don't always know why. That's not the question. The question is how. How is it going to roll over? Well, I'll make this really nice and big. When we went short right here on the 22nd of April, it was the next day that the market bounced high. It went to 26,695, made a ChapmanWave two-bar reversal, gapped down the second day, and then retested but failed to make a new high. Look at this green line here. Look at the 9-period exponential moving average. Look at the 14-period exponential moving average, the black one. So light green is 9, black is 14, and it took 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 sessions. The 10th session closed underneath the 9-period and 14-period moving average significantly, but it was only the 11th day that you really got a confirmation that the 9-period moving average had actually crossed negative. And then on the way up, it took a little while. It took 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, about 6 sessions before you got a positive crossover. You remember we went long that day. Then we went short the exact day of the top with 2 doji candles, 7 points from the top. And it was a little scary because you sat on that short. We sat on the short. And the 9-period moving average, it went to it, went under it, never closed below, then suddenly it closed below it, and then still had a couple of up days there, and then bam, it went right through it. That still didn't give you a crossover signal. It still took another couple of days before you got the crossover confirmation. So that took 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, the 13th session. And I don't think we're even close yet. Look, the 9-period moving average hasn't yet even, it's just started to turn down. So the fact that we did go short to the top of the market on Friday, that wasn't the all-time high, it was about 100 and something points off the all-time, off the most recent recovery high of 27,306. What we're looking at here is it's a process. And now this is the period, and I'll put this in here just for fun. This is the period from exactly not that day, not that day, but from the second day after the top, is where I start to expect a dark cloud cover. What do I mean about a dark cloud cover? Is it a candle? No, it's got nothing to do with the candle. It has to do with the terminology that I use for the negative overlay in the market. It could be anything. It could be, remember, it was impeachment a year ago. It was rates. It was trade war. It was everything. Today is something completely different. It is impeachment. It is trade war. It is rates. It's the same darn thing. So I've got this as a cloud cover. And I really don't want to use this particular, all right, I will. I'll call it bad news cloud cover. Does it happen or doesn't it? I don't know. How can we know? But this is where I'm anticipating that it could be. And if it isn't, it's fantastically bullish, because if it breaks into the 27,000, breaks above 27,306, closes above that in the 27,360s, wow, it's just you're talking about just a hop, skip, and a jump, and it goes to an all-time high. I think that's going to be difficult to do right now. So that's really what I wanted to do here, is discuss it in terms of, I think it's going to be difficult to do. Look at the S&P, SPX.X. That's how I get it. Same thing, MACD. I keep saying MACD because it looks like the MACD. The moving average convergence divergence is something different. I use it as a technical tool. That's already close to turning negative. This isn't even close. It's the 9-period differential. The 9-period exponential moving average here, the green one, and the 14 is the four. The black one is a 14-period moving average, and the MACD uses a 9-period differential for what I call the green faster moving average. But you can see, and look at the QQQ. Aha! All of a sudden, you've got them both turning down. You've got the black line just starting to turn down, but a sharp move down in the green line. And what about the IWM? That should be holding a little better. Yep, it is holding a little better, because it had an even better gain than the others on the days that they were not that strong. So now it's starting to follow through to the downside, and it's underneath the 14-period moving average for the first time in quite a while. So now let's just use this thing while we're talking about it for gold. So gold right now has just crossed the day's young, but so far it looks like the gold has crossed positive in the moving averages. But that's not the issue, because if you look at the real issue, as far as I'm concerned, it's the chart formation that we need to be looking at. So let's just go to that, and we'll go to the gold and the GDX, the gold here, right here. Gold is trading. It's just crossed positive. I drawn in a rectangle formation and an even larger rectangle formation. It stayed in the smaller one, and now it's trying to tackle the bigger one. But if I really go to this and I do it in great detail, what do you see? You see the usual thing. I talk about straight line moves up or down, arch formations, or cup formations. Yeah, that's all the market is. And sometimes the cup looks like a V. It's still the same pattern. So now we're talking about a rally that the MACD has not yet crossed positive, but the moving averages have. The stochastic is good, but not great at 37%. Now you're looking at gold, the gold itself. Let's just quickly go to the GDX before the break. And the GDX has crossed positive in the MACD and positive in the moving average. So this says, watch out, because gold is back in play. I'll be right back. Basil Chapman, Tiger Conditions Hour. Dow's down 14, S&P's down 5. Be right back.
If you're not currently using the TAS Profile Scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS Profile Scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today. Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay Area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Hi folks, just to finish this GDX, so the only way I can see this turning down, there has to be some really good news geopolitically. And you got to get maybe a little doji candle tomorrow, a tiny doji candle. And Thursday has to be a pretty good minus 20 drop in gold followed through on Thursday. It's Wednesday, Thursday. So tomorrow is the doji candle. Yep, Thursday pulled back. And by Friday, you're actually down, testing the 28 level, 28.50. That we were at 3 days ago. I'm not sure how we're going to do that because there is quite a bit of strife going on right now. So gold is actually looking quite good. Silver is trading, that's down 11 at 1859. Yeah, I think this is still basically that geopolitical stuff, much more because gold is leading, silver is not doing anything. So maybe that's what it is. But silver at 18.60 has 1823 to 1810, really important support, and a breakout starts above 19.15. And let's just look at crude oil here. Oh, no, let's go to the dollar, DXY. Dollar is just trading above the two moving averages, the 9 and the 14 period moving average, just stuck sideways. Let's see what the euro is doing, EUR/USD, euro-dollar currency pair. It's making the arch formation. So let's just draw that in and see how it follows through. I've got that to there and that to there. Now, anything can happen. It's just in the lower range. And the USD/JPY is the yen, the dollar-yen currency pair. Peak D, it looks like it's pulling back, and the MACD is unchanged, could cross negative. So yen looks like it could pull back a little bit. Okay, so a couple of things going on here. Let me just, I'd like very quickly to go to the questions. Jason wanted to know about FSLY. We discussed it the other day. Let me go to this. FSLY. Hi, Basil. Can you do a follow-up on FSLY for a long? Also, if you have time to look at NET, which is in the same business, a dumbed-down version of what they do is provided on the web, content closer to where you live, which speeds up your experience. Oh, if a company servers are located in San Francisco, but you're in Boston, FSLY/NET provide servers in Boston with a cache. Oh, a cached version of the content. Okay, all right, good, got it. So, meantime, back at the ranch, just let's look at the price before we go to talk about it. Let me just look at this, FSLY, which is Fastly. Oh, I remember talking about this because I said, what a strange name, Fastly. I wouldn't have known what they did, but I guess now I do. Fastly, they get you there quicker. They should be called quickly, Fastly. So Doji High at about 35, pulls back. I don't know. I think this has got a little struggle. I love what you're talking about. I think this is in play. It's an IPO. I just give it a little more time. I still say I'd like to see a test closer to the 2380, 2330 area. 2364 is the 200 period moving average. Just I'd give it a little time, and I even have a feeling from the pattern I'm looking at, if it hasn't bounced to 2835 by Friday, I'd give it all the way to Friday to get a point and a quarter higher. I think it's just kind of stuck for now. And net is Cloudflare Inc. Never heard of it. It's in leg C to the upside. Let me show what we're doing the Chapman Wave. You just go to the most obvious lowest low. That's obviously the IPO low. And you go PO. So as an IPO, this is the one that hasn't given back very much at all. I like this better, but it's newer, so it's hard to say. So it did go from the 16, 17 area all the way to just about 22. Was that a round number high? 22.08. All right. 20.08C does it today. It's down 28 cents at 20 point. I like this one. You know, it's an IPO, so I can't even talk to her. There's no history. I can just go by what you say. I think they're in areas, if they've moved nicely over the last two and a half weeks when the market's been sort of sideways, stagnant, I'm saying net looks quite nice. Let me tell you this, what I would do. I'd start a position at the 1880 to 1860 area, if you can get it. Just have patience, just put it in. And if you wait that long and it's already been to 22 and gives back 4 points, I'd make a 2-point stop. Because if it pulls back from there and it just keeps going underneath the 200-period moving average, you could try to retest the low. But give me a yell if that happens. I'm not going to say anything other than let's look at it again. I like them. I think it's maybe a little early in this market cycle to be buying the IPOs. But yes, good idea. And where would you get in? I told you that net, I'd try to get in the mid-18s. And, of course, I have to look up what it is, FSLY, right? Fastly. Holy moly. FSLY. Let me see if I can type that again. There it is. Because it failed at peak C, which had all the characteristics, even a doji candle of a peak D and a chance of a C1, C2, I'm going to say just give it a little room. 23.63 is the 200 period moving average. Give me a yell when it gets there. Let's see if it's ready for at least a starting position. But yes, keep your eye on that and keep reminding me about them for the next big cycle. These are the guys that you want to be looking at. And another question from Jim, if I can just find it here. Let me go there. I have to move over. I've got a number of keyboards in front of me here. Okay, there we go. So Jim wants to know, Basil, looking at TWO, possible entry, 13.59, and THC, looking for daily 200 EMA to active support, thoughts in at 23.39. All right, let's go there. So TW2. Now, I remember seeing this because there's TTWO, isn't it? TTWO. Yeah, which was a huge winner from the March rally into the July peak E high. Now we've got TWO different. That was to Take Two Interactive Networks. Now we've got this. I like this, Jim. It's in a leg B right now. It's above the 200 period moving average. Let it pull back a little more based on market conditions. Dow's down 104 right now. S&P's down 17. This is what I've been fearful of, that dark cloud cover. One of the reasons why we went short on Friday, the Dow, and we added another short yesterday. First time we've had shorts in a long time, and first time that I've gone back into one of the sectors that we had just stepped aside for quite a while. So 13.55 is pulled back in the market condition right now. I would say, Jim, 13, 1350 to 1320, that's kind of the support area that you want to see it hold. The MACD is good, stochastic is good, the two moving averages are good. If it pulls back to that level, they'll pull back a little bit, but I still think that's the area that I'd be getting in. I'd have a tough time buying it right now just because of market conditions. I think that there's the potential right now to have a lot of market impacted bad news, just cross currents all over the show, and therefore it limits the upside. I'm not saying where we're going on the downside just yet, but it does limit the upside. So just give us a, are you in it? Looking at two possible entries. Yeah, if you're not in it, Jim, at 1334, let it pull back a little bit, but this is one of those, the way it's moved in the weekly chart, the monthly is horrible, but that weekly chart can really improve if it can get into the 14s in October, anytime in October. So just give me a yell when you think it's pulling back. Remind me if it goes to the 1336, 1310 area, but that's where I'd be looking at it. I'll be right back. Dow's at 104. Basil Chapman, Tiger, Business Hour. Be right back.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com. The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that we'll even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Hi, folks. So in the ChapmanWave methodology, we're always looking, let me see if I can find it right here. We're always looking for that fourth highest peak. That's where we raise the foot off the accelerator, hover over the brake, because other things can happen. You can see here, I spoke about the three patterns. We're always looking for straight line up or down. We just had that in the S&P, straight line down. Cup formation, cup formation, arch formation, and the lowercase h and the y patterns. That's all we look for. But we try to identify the lowest low bar and then merely count each successively higher peak. At the fourth highest peak, we alphabetize them. Peak A is the first peak, B is the second peak, C is the third. At peak D, where we can go E, F, and G. But D is where other things can happen. It's so often that at the fourth highest peak, whew, look what we get. Here's the E-mini, 10-minute chart. High was 3,012.25. At 7 o'clock this morning, I think it was. Yep, right there, 7:20. And we're now trading at 29.72. I would say that that is quite a pullback. All right, enough with that. Let's go back to our story. Question was TWO. We did that. And another question was THO? THC. THC is... Oh, Tenet Healthcare. Tenet Healthcare, which I always see on the ticker. It's one of those stocks that does nothing. And then you'll see it on the ticker, up two, up three, and then it's down one, down two. And today it's down 64 cents at 23.34. You know, this is one that I've followed, Jim. I followed it for ages, only in that I look at it and I say, oh, what a big move. But if you don't get the big move, if you buy the top of the move, you can just watch this come down 10%, 20%. It's just one of those stocks. So I'm going to say lay off, stay away, don't do anything. It's made a peak D already in the daily chart. It went to a peak C failure. It's in a new leg B, gray leg B. And everything about it says it just needs time. But I tell you what, I'm going to say to you, if it comes back to the 21 to 20 area, and it's a 23.29 right now, give me a yell, and we'll look at it again. Actually, even close, even if it just gets to 21.80, just give me a yell. Okay. So that's that. Okay, a bunch of things that I've got here in front of me. I believe that my TFNN source, my email, there's a little problem there. I had to switch computers. And that part of the internet, I haven't transferred over yet. So I think I'm stuck. I am getting emails from people who reach me in any case. So, yeah, let me just do this, if you don't mind. I had a question about the waveform. I had a question about why if the Dow... Just keep, if you're a mega bull and you think we're going to even higher highs, why do you even bother to go short? Well, one of the reasons is we've caught most of the shorts very nicely, and there were times that I had to do it twice. Yep, absolutely. But we have very tight stops, and then when it comes in really well. But I have a technique that, for anyone who's followed me for years and years and years, you know that when I get to the D, I'm busy looking to see, can we go a little higher? This is where I'm starting to look for action. And that's exactly what we've got. Look, here's the daily chart. There's your peak D. Here's the, this is where I show my subscribers to my opening call. I go through it in detail every single, I have to tell you, I spend so much time. Look, I can 1 second just say right now, I know exactly what's going on. We've gone from a leg, a peak D, Chapman wave 5, we've gone 1, 2. This is Chapman wave 3 down. It coincides with the leg B down. There should be that red, this pinkish thick line is the 20 period exponential moving average. First time we've even touched that since we spiked above it back in around about the 3rd of September. I think that we're going to at least attempt to fill some of the gap right here from the 5th of September with a low of 26.603. Doesn't give you a time, just says that's kind of the area that I'd be looking at, all right? And we're still way above it. We're in the 200s. So now I have to write it. I have to first type it. I have to first change all the dates here. I have to put in the waveform. I always have to put in the numbers. I want to see what was the low, what was the high. That's one. Then I have to put the chart pattern, right? Remember, sine wave is what we're looking at all the time. Cup goes to arch, goes to cup, goes to arch, or straight line move, or they could combine. And now I'm looking at the MACD for the first time, just about to turn negative. And the stochastic's way down now at 72%. How quick that was. And the on-balance volume is negative. I just take one glance. Look, I've just discussed it. It's taken me about a minute and a half to 2 minutes to discuss. I just looked at it. And all of a sudden, I'm saying, hey, now I have to type it up for my subscribers. And then I do it in a 120-minute chart. Both. This is the left side with no MACD stochastics. And then on the right side. And here we have automatic... automated Chapman wave support level 26,614 in the daily chart. I don't have to type anything. For me, I could just go on to the next day right now. But I want it for my subscribers because that's the most important thing. I want them to understand the waveform. I want them to understand these little doji candles. I want them to understand the PT. I want them to understand the process that I've been going through for the past 2.5 years of developing this Chapman Wave 5 methodology, how you can get single leg up before you get the X turnaround, like here. You got your 5, and then you went down to another low. All of these things are very complex. So it's a teaching process. It's a process that says, these are levels that we're watching. This is what we're looking at. This is why we're a little nervous. This is the reason why we've gone short. This is what's acting well, etc. And then I have to type that out. So it's a very big process. Love doing it, except it's very time consuming. So I just wanted to mention, one of the questions I had was, so why do I even think of going short? It's because I've developed over these 30, 40, whatever number of years that I've been making a daily call on the Dow, I've been developing these techniques. I want to use them. I've got short-term traders. I've got long-term traders. We've got a dollar position that goes back to April of 2018. We've got a bank position that goes back to December. You know, I try to keep the positions as long as we can. So what we're looking at here is, look, the MACD finally has crossed negative, and that's what I was saying. But the two key moving averages are not doing what they should yet. They will, I think, but right now they're still saying that there's some intrinsic support levels you got to be careful of. That means your timing for any short position has to be pluperfect. It has to be perfect because you have to give it room. I don't want to be shorting right now, even if I think we're going lower, because I want the risk reward for subscribers. I don't want to be shorting here 26,812. Next thing we bounce 200 points to the upside. It's tough. That makes it tough. So it means that that's the timing that I do, and that's what I've done for years and years and years. And a lot of times it's right on, and sometimes it misses. What can I say? All right. Next thing I wanted to do is I wanted to I had something all planned for today. Oh, I wanted to show you why I was looking at the market and saying I'm still very cautious, and that's because of the action of the transports. Not that I'm a Dow theory follower, but I like to put them together. And right now, the Dow transports are down $1.45 at 185.91, down 0.77%. And the Dow's now down 160. I'll be right back.
If you're in the CD market and looking for a secure investment, the Tiger First Mortgage Program may work for you. The security for these first mortgages are building lots in the tax opportunity zone in St. Petersburg, Florida. The Tax Act of 2018 set up tax-free zones across the country where you can build and hold for 10 years and pay no tax on the profits, which makes these lots valuable. The investment is anywhere from $30,000 to $75,000. The interest paid is 7% yearly, paid on a monthly basis. According to Bankrate.com, the best rate for a 4-year CD in the country as of February 20th is 3.1%. A $50,000 investment at a normal 4-year CD rate of 3.1% would give you income of $1,550 per year or $6,200 over the 4-year period. That same $50,000 investment in the Tiger First Mortgage Program would give you $3,500 per year or $14,000 over the 4 years. Which would you prefer, $6,200 or $14,000 of interest on your investment? If you would like more information about the Tiger First Mortgage Program, you can call me at 877-518-9190. That's 877-518-9190.
If you're a trader in the market looking for exposure to gold or gold mining equities, then now is a perfect time to sign up for Tom O'Brien's Gold Report. The summer is over, gold is trading back above $1,500, and the 10-year treasury is hovering at around 1.5%. Tom O'Brien has been writing his weekly gold report for almost 18 years. There's no one that knows more about how the gold market trades and how gold mining equities react. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to lose. Every Monday morning, Tom publishes his weekly gold report with coverage of gold, silver, bonds, the XAU, HUI, GDX, the dollar, as well as more than 30 different mining equities. As of September 3rd, Gold Report subscribers have 5 active open positions with an average unrealized profit of almost 38% for each position. To see for yourself the types of profitable trades that are recommended within the Gold Report, sign up today by visiting TFNN.com. Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Hi, folks. So let's go to the TLT. The TLT is up sharply. It's up $1.60. So as the market becomes more volatile, the normal history, and we haven't been in a real normal period at this stage, but normally I would just automatically say, watch money migrate from the volatility of stocks to the stability of bonds. That's the thinking. Okay, we know that bonds are... when you talk stability, when you're looking at just in a couple of months going from 120 to 148, I would say that is pretty volatile for bonds. Okay, so the history can change, but it's the speed with which we've moved up. Look, we've come down sharply like this before, but very seldom do we go up. It usually takes a lot longer. Look at this, the big move back in July of 2015, somewhere in the 110, 111 area, goes to 143, but it goes all the way there. It takes a year to do that. We've gone from December... November of 2018, and we've already broken the previous high. We went from a lower level, 111.90. Oh, so that wasn't 110. That was right there, 114 to 143. We've gone from 111 to 148, and the digestion was pretty severe. 148 to 136, 12 points. 12 points, that's what, about 9%? Whew. And now it's moving up. So be careful. All right, now I just wanted to have another look at HGX. That is the Philadelphia Housing Sector Index. There was a report I thought I heard on the radio, was it, that the housing starts, I think, was it the starts that were a little bit lower this year, this month? Was it a month after month, or 3 months, or quarters? I don't know. But what a fantastic move, going from the low of 227 to the most, to today's high of 340, 113 points. That's, I mean, yeah, we're talking about a third in housing. Of course, it came down in the same amount of time. So this is very important because the housing sector index, Philadelphia housing sector index, trading at 338.23, up 31, is in fact up today. But we have to consider that it's pulled back from the high of 340.60 to 338.25. Technicals are still very good. So I'm really watching this because if you finally get the housing sector index pulling back, and now with rates even lower because the bonds are spiking, that would not be a good sign, because it would be saying something else is going on. So far, everything's good, very nice. I love this little crawl to the upside, holding the 9-period exponential moving average. I call it walking the 9 EMA. I love the fact that the 9-period differential in the MACD on the daily basis is still strong. It is tilting down, but it's still very strong. And the stochastic's at 88%. So we've got to watch the housing sector as some kind of a benchmark. Now, I had a question about steel. So, you know, I just don't think it's there yet. You've got to be careful with steel. I spoke about this the other day when we were looking at U.S. steel, and I said the sector is still not ready. So this is kind of an attempt for the person who was trying to get in, and maybe, you know, he could have made some money, I'm not sure. But it did move up from where he entered, and that's very good. But you've got to put in stops. I don't think it's ready. I don't think China is going to be a big help for the steel industry just yet. Not yet, anyway. So let me do this. I wanted to show you that. Let me see where we are in the E-mini. E-mini 10-minute chart. Lower lows, lower lows, lower lows. Lower highs, lower highs, lower highs. 29.66. Flat stochastic at 8%. Not so good. And the MACD is expanding. We're getting close. No, we just went right through the 29.78 support. Now, is there another support? Yes, there is, 29.62. 29.62 is the automated ChapmanWave 2-minute support. Can a 2-minute beat a 10-minute? I'm not so sure. Well, we'll see. Okay, now there are a couple of questions coming in here. I needed to just see if I can reach over. This is not going to be so easy. Let me see if I can get that. Yeah, Paul says every major stock average is on a sell right now. So, Paul, I distinguish between a sell mode and a sell signal. You cannot get a sell mode until you get a sell signal. Sometimes you get a sell signal on a Friday that automatically upgrades within the same notation that day because it's the end of the week. So let's just have a look here. In the middle of the week, we've got the Dow. Where is it now? INDU. Yes, it's broken that support at 26.776. MACD has now crossed negative quite sharply, but this is the first time, so anything can happen here. Yeah, this is, you know, the weekly chart is ho-hum. We've seen this before. Got tremendous support at, let me just see, at 26,580, around about there, and 26,675. So 9-period is 675. And five 570 black line. Oh, there it is. Okay. Yeah, and the 14-period is 26,000. Why am I missing it? I can't get it. Come on, I'll move that away. There you are. Okay, 26,580. Okay. So those are your support levels. Anything can happen. It's very news-driven. Let's go back to this chart. Remember what we said right here? I said this is the news, the dark cloud cover, $INDU. There it is, bad news, dark cloud cover, and I drew in the rectangle, and that's what we're looking at. And I said you don't know how long it can last for, but we're in the time frame where it should start 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. This is the ninth bar. I said between 8 and I think I said 11 bars, we can start to see the test of the 14-period moving average. And here we are. For the first time, we're seeing a test of the 14-period moving average. All right. So we've covered a chunk. A question about the XLF, which is the bank index. XLF, just hit the wrong thing. XLF, there it is. XLF is the financial spider fund, trading at 27.88. It's only down 25 cents. I say only because, I shouldn't say only. I should say it's down 25 cents. And it's making the potential for an arch formation. Look right here. Go to the low over there. I'm going to actually make it tighter. Make it the low right there. Peak D, remember we went to a peak D, but this one squeaked to an E, slightly higher. And now I can put a down arrow coming up. So now the XLF is in a sell signal, not yet a sell mode, because the MACD hasn't crossed negative. Stochastic has gone 80%, but this is just the start of a move down. But at the same time, I need to put in the other part of the puzzle, which is the right side of the arch. And there it is. So now we're looking at this particular low right here of 2773. And then right there, 2737 is key support for the XLF. All right. Oh, my goodness, the last section's coming up. Basil Chapman, Dow's down 173, S&P's down 26. I'll be right back straight after this important message.
I'm certain you are or strive to be one of the best of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step by step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
If you haven't checked out the newsletters page of TFNN.com, what are you waiting for? All of the TFNN newsletters are informative, up-to-date, affordable, and a must-have for every trader looking to gain a competitive informational edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets to offer you the very latest in market news. Plus, new subscribers get to test drive our newsletters risk-free for 30 days. From all aspects of the markets, including stocks, bonds, metals, commodities, and tech, there's a newsletter to fit your needs exclusively from TFNN. Stay informed each day you trade and get that competitive edge that will help you stay ahead of the game. Visit our newsletters page by going to TFNN.com and click the newsletters button near the top of the page. TFNN.com, educating investors.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated folic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They've been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Hi, folks. This is Steve Rhodes. Stay tuned for another great hour of the Trader's Edge heard here at TFNN.com.
We're back. Don't forget, Steve Rhodes comes up straight after my show, then Dave White, then Tom O'Brien. I will be on with Brian this afternoon, with Tom O'Brien this afternoon. So we're looking at 64.66 down $1.12 in the IAI. It's held extremely well. I say to subscribers, we're long. I say to subscribers, I think we've got to be careful here because this is not going to be an alternate count, F/B. I think it's an F. And we need to see how it holds the key 65 support. Whoops, it's gone down to 64.66. And there's that double top in the weekly chart. Went to a slightly higher high, and that's going to probably be a PG. Got to watch this one closely because it's telling us that the brokerage area is now a little bit vulnerable. Got to respect that. SMHs, the SMHs, the semiconductor index, trading at 117.75, down 2.22. Here again, same thing, right shoulder failure in the weekly chart, made a peak E In the daily chart, just for clarification, I should mention that we are short, subscribers are short the semiconductor index. This is going to be very important because this is where the strength is suddenly coming in every time. And I'm still hearing reports that things are a little bit better, but nothing like the prices seem to indicate. I don't know if there's going to be a regression to the mean. I don't even know if that's even a term that the semiconductors will understand. But in the meantime, at 117.84, it does say we've got a little bit of a cushion. Because if this comes back, how the SMHs over the next 2 weeks deals with 115 to 114 moving average support in the weekly chart is going to be really important. Takes it out, that's going to say a little bit deeper correction coming up than just a mild breather. So be careful. All right, I'm about to hand you over to Steve Rhodes. And before I do that, let me just say that the volatility index, the VIX index right here, VIX.X, is up sharply. It's up, I said to subscribers this morning, for the TVIX that I look at, if it moves up sharply, the TVIX, same sort of thing, is two times long. It was at in the 13s. I said if it gets over 13, what did I say? 13 over 13, let me just read it to you quickly. TVIX. Cannot get upside traction until over 15.50s. Wow. So the TVIX, did I write that correctly? Yeah, 15.50s is traction. What I mean is sustaining, not just a pop-up and then the VIX phase, but sustaining the move. Have a wonderful day. See you a little later with Tom. Otherwise, check out my opening call, my daily.